Welcome to a combing session. I have two sets of combs here and I'm going to do some experimenting with them to show you some of the differences between them. I think this is really interesting. They are very similar. They're all two pitch hand combs from Mudgercraft. These ones are the standard hand combs and these would be classified as fine combs. You can use these for combing anything from medium fibres like Romney and Corriedale right through to Merino, and I would use these down to about 18 micron. And then these are the extra fine combs. So you can use these for your luxury fibres really. They're also double pitch. And the tines are just a little bit closer together. I'll start with some combing here. I have some very, very fine, beautiful fine merino. And I'm just going to split it in half. Approximately, I'm not going to weigh these small amounts. I'm going to do half with the standard fine and half with the extra fine. And we'll just have a look at the results and also at the waste that's left over. This one is a beautiful merino. It's fairly sturdy. It's got quite a good length staple. It's very, very fine. It's also a little bit staticky, so we'll have to see how that goes. So I thought this would make a good comparison fibre because this is one of those luxury fibres. I would say this is probably about 15 micron. It's really, really beautifully fine and soft. I'm just putting all the tips together. I often don't worry about that. But if you're being a bit purist, then you want to have all the tips together and you load the cut end onto the comb. I'm just going to load this onto the comb, just gently. With any combs and with any combing, you don't want to overload the combs, especially if you're doing a little trial like I'm doing here too. Okay. So I've got this loaded on. I'm just going to make sure it's nice and loose at the back. Could put a bit more on. I do have more I can use. Make sure we get enough on there to comb. That should do. Okay, so when you're combing, let's make sure it's nice and loose at the back. I have a stationary comb. And I'll just move these out of the way. And this is my moving comb. It doesn't matter which way your hands work. Might be the opposite to me if you're left-handed or if it's more comfortable that way. You can see the static is already. Look at that. I don't have a spray, so I will persevere. But basically when you're combing, you're starting at the tips and working your way in towards the tines. And now I've got most of it off that and onto this comb. So now I'm going to start swiping it down and pulling it back. This is not going to need a lot of combing. It's already looking really lovely. It's going to be fun taking it off with all that static. But we shall see what we can do. Okay. I could give this some more passes, but this is actually looking quite nicely prepared. I'll just do one more pass just to be sure we've got out all the neps. So when I do my comparison with the extra fine cards, I'll make sure I do two passes with that as well. So it's a good comparison. I'll bring it back down. I can still see a few teeny neps in there. But at this point, I don't think they're going to come out any further. And this is where the fineness of the combs does come into play, because the smaller the neps, the narrower you want the gap between the tines, because that's what lets the neps come through. Okay, so this is looking quite nice. Some of these little ends here are a little bit bouncy. Let's take this off and we'll see what we get. Then I'll do the same thing on the other combs. So I don't use a diz, I literally just hold my comb down against the tabletop. Make sure the fibre is lifted up at the back and loose. And I just carefully draft that away from the comb. And as soon as I see neps start to come through, that's where I'll stop. And there is my beautiful combed fiber. So I'll just put that there. What we're going to do is I'll comb them both and then hold them up to the light. And then we'll really get to see through the middle of that combed top, that's what it is now. Then we'll see what neps are there, what lumps there might be left in there. So this is exactly the same fibre from the same part of the sheep. It's been washed together and prepared together. Really is a beautiful fleece. I want to make sure it's about the same, because not just for the comparison of what's combed, but also of the comparison of what's left behind on the comb. Because what you will find with the extra fine combs is you're likely to get a bit more waste with them. And that's not a bad thing. People worry a lot about getting too much waste when they're combing. But that's one of the reasons you are combing, is to remove all the bits you don't want. The static. Wow, it's so sticky. It seems to be even more staticky on these combs. But I want to be careful that it's not folded over when I'm combing it, that I'm just getting it from the tips. I have got a spray bottle here. Let's see. Hopefully this won't skew the results. It's just water in there. Still a little bit more staticky than I'd like, but that has improved it. At least it's not completely doubling back onto the comb. Okay, so I'm just... That was my first pass. I'm putting it back onto my stationary comb. Let's pull this out a bit. There we go. Much more manageable. So this is my second pass. Just about done. Okay. It's two passes. Make sure it's nice and loose at the back. There we go, we'll take this one off. Here we have our second piece. Some just such beautiful fibre. I love combing because this is the result. It's just gorgeous. Okay, so first of all, we'll just compare the waste between the two. You can see there is more on the extra fine comb. It's not substantially more, but I'd say at least another 50% more what's on there. And we can lay these side by side. I think what we're going to have to do is hold them up to the light to really get a good idea of what is in there. So let's do that. So here we have the extra fine. And here is, let me just zoom out. There we go. So on the left we have the fibre combed on the standard fine combs. And on the right we have the extra fine. And although they both have a nice open prep, you can see the one on the left has a few more little neps in there than the one on the right. The other thing to note that will also make a difference is that the prep of this 15 micron merino on the extra fine combs is actually more even as well. You can kind of see in the thickness of it. I feel that the standard comb just doesn't quite match up to the evenness and the thickness of the top from the extra fine comb with this fiber. So what we'll do now is let's go to a slightly coarser fiber and see what happens. So this time what I have is, let's see where it is, I have some pole width, and I would say this is about probably a 23 micron fiber. It has a nice handle. It's been dyed, whereas the other one hasn't, but I don't think that's going to make too much difference to our comparison test because we're using the same fiber on both combs, sets of combs. So I'm just going to make sure I'm only putting locks through, I'm not putting any second cuts into the mix. Pulling this out from the tips. It's all about the same staple length. Second cut in there I don't want. Okay, I think that's a fair test. So let me put this one onto the standard fine. Now if you go to the Mudgercraft YouTube channel, you may already be on it, there is a fantastic video there that we did with Pat Old demonstrating using these combs with some long locks with, I believe she was using Romney. So that's a step up again in coarseness of the fibre, the micron count. Dust coming out. Okay, so I've got my pole width loaded up here. I'm going to start at the tips and work my way across. So that was one pass, this is my second pass. You can see these tips coming through. Some of the tips may be breaking on this. It's another great thing about combing is it takes out anything that might break in your fibre, and by the time you've taken it off the combs you have all fibres of the same length. Any broken ones are going to stay behind on the comb as waste, which is what we want. Want breaky fluff in our blends. Okay, I'm gonna take this off, taking from the tips, dust. This one has a very different feel to it. It's a lovely piece of prepared combed fiber. So let's do the same thing now. I'll leave the waste on that one. Do the same thing now with our other comb, the extra fine. And this is where, personally, if you're doing a lot of this type of micron fiber, I don't think you need to really be doing this on the extra fine combs. So if you're wondering about which combs to purchase, Think about what kinds of fibres you're most often combing. If you've got lots of luxury fibres, and you know, anything from sort of the very, very finest microns through to, I would say up to about 18 microns, so it's a 12 to 18 super fine fibres, they're going to be great on these combs. Doesn't mean you can't comb something that's coarser on them, you certainly can, but we will see the result very soon, and we'll also compare the amount of waste that we're left with. You might find that even if you're happy with the result on this one, which I'm sure we will get a nice result, the amount of waste compared to the return that we're getting from it is what will make the difference. So what I mean is, if you're getting the same result, a nicely prepared combed top, but one set of combs creates more waste for the same result, then go for the set of combs that creates less waste and the result that you're happy with. Whereas with that merino that we just did, I feel like the amount of waste was higher with the extra fine combs, but the result was so much better, I think it's worthwhile having the extra waste. So that was one pass. So that's something that you sort of need to weigh up for yourself. And again, you know, figure out what you're mostly going to be combing. And I'd say if you're mostly going to be combing these sort of medium, fine to medium fibres, then the standard combs are perfectly good. Also for right through to Corriedale and in Romney and some of those longer locks, if you've got a nice fine Leicester that you want to comb, then that would work too. Okay, now we'll take this off. More dust. Must have been a mucky fleece. Able to lift it up at the back. This is the other thing, is it's going to be more difficult to draw off the extra fine combs when you've got a thicker micron fleece on there. It just wants to hold on a little bit more. If you get completely stuck, bring your hand back a little bit, make sure you're not pulling on both ends of the staple, and also just lift it up at the back, give it a little wiggle. Okay, that is another lovely piece of fluff. So here's our two to compare. That's interesting, we've got more from the extra fine comb. I may have loaded more up. But let's have a look at the waste first. So this is from the extra fine. This is from the fine. So there's quite a bit more. This is the extra fine. In my right hand, I'd say this again, very much like with the merino, it's probably about 50% more with the extra fine combs, more waste. So let's have a look at the result and see if it was worth it. So if I hold these up together, I am not seeing a great deal of difference between them. There's very few naps, there's no unusual structure to it. They're both about the same kind of density, nice light and airy. And if we turn this around, in my left hand, fine comb, in my right, extra fine. And there's really not too much to see in here, is there? In terms of the difference between them, there's like one or two tiny little wee nips. But otherwise, I think it's very comparable. So to me, that says there's no advantage to having the extra fine combs when you're doing this kind of fibre, this sort of medium weight, medium micron fibre.
especially when it's quite an open fluff like this too. And the amount of waste that we got off each one, we've lost more of the fluff on the extra fine carders to no great gain in terms of quality of prep. So definitely something to keep in mind there. So my last prep here is going to be a blend. Let's see how well each of these blends some fibre, and I think we'll do the same blend on each. I've got some baby camel, so I'll use some of that. And here's my extra fine, put it on together, so I'm doing about the same amount. And I've got some, this is Wakaya Alpaca, very nice fibre also. That on, and let's put on some of this, let's put on some of this merino. Put a little bit of that on there. It's a wee bit longer in staple than the camel, but not so much that I think it'll make a big difference. And if you noticed, I'm not putting this on with the cut end first. There's not a great deal of point in that at this stage because I'm using fibre that's already been carded and made into commercial top. It's not all done with all the staples pointing in the same direction. And to be honest, my spinning is not that exact that it will make too much of a difference. Okay, so let's start with blending these with my standard fine combs. Must just be a static day today. Now it's quite good having the white in this because it's going to tell us how much it's blending. And I'll try and do complete pass each time because we'll have a little count up of how many passes it takes to get a nice even blend. It's getting there. So these really are beautiful luxury fibres. I've got neps coming through. What I do with these neps that come through like that, especially when they're down the end here, is I just put my comb through on that side of them. And so hopefully they'll pull out and end up on the back of this comb. That's the goal. Well, I think my colours are blended quite well now, so I'm just going to take this blend off. I kind of lost count of how many passes I'd done, but I think it was around 4 or 5, so we'll see how long it takes on the other combs to blend. It's almost skin tone. So can you see there's a few little neps in there I'm not super happy with. Those have come from the merino. But let's see how my extra fine combs do with the same blend. Let's pop that over there. Okay. So we're going to start with the tips and spray it up. It's blending quite nicely. Certainly transferring quite nicely from comb to comb. How's that looking? I think I've done one less pass than I did with the other combs. Right, I think I'll leave it at that. Okay, lift it up at the back. I'm gonna draft this off. You can see a few little naps along here, sort of waiting in the wings. But no, don't you come off. As soon as they start to pull through, there's one there. You kind of want to stop about that time because you don't want to start pulling more of them through. And then we have it. Oh wow. That is a lovely prep. So let's hold them up side by side. Here we go. Prep on the left, standard fine. Prep on the right, extra fine. And again, that extra fine with these luxury fibres has just done a better job. It's more evenly spread. It doesn't have as many neps. Again, I'm not saying it's 100% perfect. Look, there's one there. But when you hold up to the light, you can really see what's inside that prep. Both would be lovely to spin, but with one on the left, I'm going to be pulling out little bumps a bit more often than I would with this one. We'll just have a quick look at the amount of waste we had left. It's actually not very different. Fine, extra fine. Quite similar. So that's interesting too. So there we have it. We have the extra fine 15 micron merino, we have the somewhat coarser but still really nice Polworth, and of course the luxury blend with the baby camel and the alpaca and that same merino in here. As you can see, there is some difference between the way the combs work depending on the fibre that you put on them. And my suggestion here is, if you're wondering which combs to get, just consider the kinds of fibres you're mostly combing. If you're mostly combing these super fine luxury fibres, then definitely go for the extra fine combs, because they will give you a more even prep with these fibres and they will reduce the amount of neps that come out on the other side. If you've got more sort of, you know, 18 to 24 micron fibre, then perfectly fine with the standard fine combs. They'll do a gorgeous job for you. They'll minimise the amount of waste that you get with it. And they have the added advantage of you can also use them, you know, right up to like a 30 micron type longer wool. As well, I use them quite often for the Gotland that we have, and they do a nice job. I probably wouldn't bother with the Gotland on my extra fine combs. It's kind of overkill. Really, I'd end up with a lot more waste than I'd need, and no great advantage in the final preparation from that. So, you know, just weigh up what kind of fibres you're mostly going to. It's much like choosing the tines on a drum carder. What are you mostly going to be working with, and what sort of fibres, what sort of prep are you wanting? Do you want something nice and smooth, or you don't mind if it's got a few neps to pull out?
if you have a wider range of fibres to work with. I personally use both sets of combs often enough to justify having two sets of combs. Same as I have two different drums for my drum cutter. I have a 128 TPI drum for my fine fibres, and I have a 76 for my arty bats and my curlier fibres like the Gotlands and so on. So yeah, it's just a choice that you make depending on what you're going to be combing and preparing. So hopefully that has given you some insight into the differences between the extra fine and standard fine combs from Mudgercraft. Obviously other advantages with these combs is the size and the weight. They're small, they're light, they still prepare a nice quantity of fibre, and they're not too sharp. They slide through the fibres beautifully. It's stainless steel, it's never going to rust. They don't get wonky because of the way they are added to the wood. They stay nice and straight, and they're not pin sharp, so it's much harder to injure yourself with these combs than with some of those really super sharp ones. So those are the things that are the same between them. Anyway, happy combing, and I hope you enjoy your beautiful worsted combed top prep.